The previous video, Repairing Surface Defects in the SI8 Engine Geometry, Part 2, described how to diagnose and repair surface defects. This video will describe how to prepare the piston for motion. Verify that you have flagged all the boundaries and repaired any surface defects before continuing. To ensure accurate results, you may need to adjust the geometry in an STL file. For example, the piston and liner may be misaligned, or the piston may not be precisely at bottom dead center, which also affects the compression ratio and or the squish volume. Additionally, inaccurate velocity initialization and engine motion output may occur if, for an inline engine, the piston motion is not in the Z direction. You must verify that the liner consists of a single row of triangles and that the vertices along the top and bottom of the liner are aligned in the direction of piston motion. Otherwise, problems will occur when the liner deforms while moving. Although the liner in this geometry consists of only one row of triangles, we will demonstrate how to delete and recreate the liner. In the geometry dock, click on the Repair button and then on the Delete tab. Verify that the deletion type is set to triangle and select By Boundary from the Selection Filter drop-down menu. Then, click on the liner to select all of the liner triangles and click Apply. This will delete all of the surface triangles that make up the liner. Go to Geometry, Measure, Direction. Select Arc Normal. Choose three approximately equidistant vertices on the perimeter of the piston per the right-hand rule and click Apply. Verify that in the message log, piston normal vector is 0, 0, 1. Now, we will recreate the liner. In the geometry dock, click the Create button, and then the Triangle tab. Choose the Loft Directionally Radio button. Check the Select First Set of Edges checkbox, and use the By Arc Selection filter to click on any edge that forms a curve around the piston. Next, check the Select Second Set of Edges checkbox and click on any edge that forms a curve around the head. Set the align vector to the piston arc normal that we previously measured. Choose Liner from the Placed in Boundary drop-down menu and click Apply. Converge Studio will create a single row of triangles extending from the piston to the head and place them in the liner boundary. Verify that the not assigned boundary contains zero triangles to make sure that all of the new liner triangles are in the liner boundary. Now that you have ensured that the liner boundary consists of only one row of triangles, you must align the liner vertices vertically. You should complete the alignment process even if you think that the vertices are aligned to ensure you avoid mass conservation errors. To align these vertices, click on the Repair button and then on the Align tab. Check Select First Set of Edges and use the Edge Selection Criterion in the By Arc Selection filter to click on an edge along the top of the liner. Next, check the Select Second Set of Edges checkbox and click on the edge along the bottom of the liner. In the Align Vector field, enter 0, 0, 1 because the piston moves in the Z direction. Click Apply, and Converge Studio will shift the vertices such that the vertices at the top and bottom of the liner are now aligned along the Z direction. Now that you have aligned the liner vertices, you are ready to begin setting up the case. The next video, Case Setup Part 1, will begin the case setup process in Converge Studio.